Hello friends, in the previous video we introduced what a relation is. Today we will see some types of relations: reflexive, symmetric, antisymmetric and transitive. So let's start with the reflexive relation. What is a reflexive relation? A relation on a set A is called reflexive if A, A belongs to the relation for every element A belongs to set A. Meaning that if for all the elements in the A, A is related to A, then we say that such a relation is reflexive. Let's see it with an example. Consider the following relations on set 1, 2, 3, 4. So here R1, R2, R3 and R4 are the four relations given. The question is, which of these relations are reflexive? Again, the set here we are considering is the set 1, 2, 3, 4. For any relation to be reflexive, it should contain 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 and 4, 4 to be reflexive. Because we know from the definition of reflexive relation, a relation on set A is said to be reflexive for all A, A, A belongs to R. So here, if you take R1, we have 1, 2, 2 and 4, 4 in it, but no 3, 3. Hence, it's not a reflexive relation. And taking R2, 1, 1 is only there. 2, 2, 3, 3 and 4, 4 are missing. So R2 is not a reflexive relation. R3 has 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 and 4, 4. Hence, these four are there in this R3. It is a reflexive relation. Now R4. R4 has 1, 2, 2 and 3, 3 but not 4, 4. Since 4, 4 is not there in R4, R4 is not a reflexive relation. Okay, is the divides relation on set of positive integers a reflexive relation? We know that to be reflexive, it have to be the case that for all A, A, A belongs to R. So here the relation is the divides relation, right? So we have to check if A divides A for any element A in the set of positive integer set. So it is the case that for all A, A divides A. So hence A is related to A for all the elements A. Hence it is a reflexive relation. Now we ask, when is a relation symmetric? A relation R on set A is called symmetric if B, A belongs to the relation whenever A, B belongs to the relation for all A, B belongs to the set A. Meaning that whenever A, B is present in a relation, then it has to be the case that B, A should present in the relation for the relation to be symmetric. Again, let's see it with an example. Consider the following relations on the set 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, here there are four relations R1, R2, R3 and R4. The question is, which of these relations are symmetric? Okay, R1 is not symmetric because 3, 4 is present but 4, 3 is not present. So whenever A, B is in relation, it has to be the case that B, A should be in the relation for that relation to be symmetric, right? So R1 is not a symmetric relation because 4, 3 is not present. Now R2 is a symmetric relation because whenever A, B is present, B, is also present. R3 is a symmetric relation again because whenever A, B is present, B, A is also present. Okay. Now R4 is not symmetric because 1, 3 is present but there is no 3, 1 in the relation R4. And hence R4 is not a symmetric relation. Is the divides relation on the set of positive integers a symmetric relation? No, because 1 divides 2, right? So 1 is related to 2, but whether 2 is related to 1, 2 does not divide 1, right? So 2 does not related to 1, 2 is not related to 1. Hence we have 1, 2 in the relation but 2, 1 is not present in the relation, and hence this relation is not symmetric. Now we ask, when is a relation anti-symmetric? A relation R on set A, such that for all A, B belongs to the set A, if A, B is in the relation and B, A is in the relation, then it is the case that A equal to B. Such a relation is called antisymmetric relation. For example, if 1,2 is in a relation and 2,1 is in a relation, then that relation is not antisymmetric because 1 is not equal to 2. Let's see it with an example. Consider the following relations on set 1,2,3,4. Again, here there are 4 relations R1, R2, R3 and R4. The question is, which of these relations are antisymmetric? Now, if you look at the relation R1, 1,2 is present and 2,1 is present, but 1 is not same as 2, right? And hence R1 is not an antisymmetric relation. Looking at R2, we get that 1,2 is present and 2,1 is present, but again 1 is not same as 2, hence R2 is also not an antisymmetric relation. Again, in R3 relation, we get that 1,2 and 2,1 both are present. That should not happen, right? Because 1 is not same as 2. Again, R3 is not an antisymmetric relation. Looking at R4, we have 1,4 and 4,1 present. But 1 is not same as 4, right? And hence, R4 is also not an antisymmetric relation. An antisymmetric relation example will be like this. Is the divides relation on set of positive integers an antisymmetric relation? Yes, it is an example for an antisymmetric relation, as if a comma b is in the relation and b comma a is in the relation, then it is the case that a equal to b. To prove that, let's take the contrapositive of that statement and then prove. So the contrapositive will be like this. If a is not equal to b, then it is not the case that a comma b belongs to R and b comma a belongs to R. So we know that divides relation on set of positive integers is not symmetric, right? So a comma b belongs to R doesn't imply b comma a belongs to R, or in other words, we can precisely say that a comma b belongs to R implies b comma a doesn't belong to R. And hence, in the divides relation on the set of positive integers set, we can be sure that a comma b belongs to R and b comma a belongs to R won't happen. Okay, so that means we have proved our statement. Okay, and hence our relation is antisymmetric relation. Now we ask, when a relation is transitive. A relation R on set A is called transitive if whenever a comma b is in the relation and b comma c is in the relation, then a comma c is in the relation for all a comma b comma c belong to set A. Let's see it with an example. Consider the following relations on set 1,2,3,4. Again, here there are 4 relations R1, R2, R3 and R4. The question is, which of these relations are transitive? Okay, let's see the first relation R1. So if you see R1, you take any a comma b and b comma c belonging to that relation, a comma c will be in the relation R1. Okay, so hence R1 is a transitive relation. Now looking at R2, R2 is not transitive because 2,1 is present, 1,2 is present, but 2,2 is not present in the relation. We know that if a comma b and b comma c is present, then it has to be the case that a comma c should be present in the relation for that relation to be transitive. So here 2,1 is present and 1,2 is present, but 2,2 is not present, and hence R2 is not transitive relation. Looking at R3, we have 1,4 belonging to R3 and 4,1 belonging to R3. Okay, so 4,1 and 1,4 implies 4,4, but 4,4 is not present in the R3 relation, and hence R3 is not transitive. Looking at R4, in the R4 relation 1,4 is present and 4,1 is present, right? So looking at this way, 4,1 is present and 1,4 is present, but 4,4 is not present, hence R4 is also not transitive relation. So only R1 is transitive relation here. Next question, is the divides relation on set of positive integers a transitive relation? Yes, it is. Now if you see, we have to prove that a comma b belongs to R and b comma c belongs to R implies a comma c belongs to R for all a comma b comma c belongs to set A. So here the set is a set of positive integers set, alright. Now the relation is a divides relation, so we have to prove that if A divides B and B divides C, then it is the case that A divides C for all a comma b comma c belonging to the set of positive integers. Okay, now A divides B implies that B equal to A into k, where k is some positive integer. Now b divide c implies that c equal to b into some positive integer p. Okay, so here k and p belong to a positive integer. So here b equal to ak, c equal to bp. That's we know, right? Now since c equal to bp, we can write c as a into k into p, because b equal to ak, right? So c equal to a into kp, where since k and p are both positive integers, kp is also a positive integer. So c equal to a into some positive integer, meaning that a divides c. So we get that if a divides b and b divides c, then a divides c. So using universal generalization, we can say that it is the case for all a comma b comma c belonging to the set of positive integers, and hence the relation is transitive. Okay, so in this video we have covered what is reflexive relation, symmetric relation, anti-symmetric and transitive relation with examples. Okay.